Hi guys, this is Jackson here and today I'm going to show you how to convert a hand-drawn sketch like this into a digital art like this. So for that, the first thing that you need to do is take a photo of the image. You should take it clearly. It should not disorient the image. It should be straight. And also make sure that there is no shadows or anything as such. If you see now, currently my shadow is coming. So try to somehow take the photo in such a way that there is no shadow. And also the shape of the image remains original. So for convenience sake, I have already taken the photo of this painting here. So I've used my iPhone camera itself. So if you see here, there is no shadow in this. Also try to make sure that the photo is in such a way that there is no other blemishes or any other dark spots other than the line sketch only. So when we are converting this on the computer, there will be only either black areas or white areas, no other colors in between. So once you have done that, you can share your photo to your laptop.
So I have a iPhone and a MacBook here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to share this image to my laptop via AirDrop. Make sure that you use either AirDrop in case if you have a MacBook, or if you have a Windows or Linux system, then use the normal file transfer by connecting the phone via the USB cable or something like that. Don't use WhatsApp because that will lower the quality of the image.
So once you have downloaded the image on your system, whether it is a Windows or a Mac or Linux, any system, you can first view the image on the laptop. So as you can see here, this is a fine image. It should have a good resolution, something that you can modify easily. So once you download the image, you need an application known as GIMP. So the GIMP stands for GNU Image Manipulation Program. So what GIMP is that it's an alternative to Photoshop. It is open source and it is available for free to download. So you just have to Google GIMP, and you can visit the GIMP official website, gimp.org, and you can download. So it is a free application, and the size of this application is below 500 MB. So this has some basic features which are there in Photoshop. So we'll be using this tool. It is available for all kind of operating systems. It works for Mac, it works for Linux, it works for Windows as well. So what we have to do is we have to right click on the image and open it with GIMP. So once the image has loaded in GIMP, you will see something like this. So in case if the image is in the wrong orientation, then what you can do is you can go to image and then transform, and then either transform it as per your need. So for me, I need to rotate it anti-clockwise 90 degrees. So I'll do transform, rotate 90 degree anti-clockwise. So now the image is in a proper position. Once I do that, what I'll do is I'll try to convert this image to black and white. So to do that, the option that I'll be using is in GIMP, click on colors in the header and then click on brightness and contrast. So this small pop-up will come up. So what you have to do is the contrast sidebar, that is slide bar that is there here, you have to drag it good enough until the image is completely black and white. Don't drag it completely to the opposite end, because that might make the black part of the image also a bit a different color, kind of grayed out. So just use it up to the level that all the non-black parts have become white. So as you can see here, I have moved it to 63 here, and my image has almost become black and white. So I'll click on OK and apply this. Once that is done, what I'll do is I need to remove this white part. I need to convert it to transparency. We need to select this first. So right click on the mouse, or you can go to select in the header, either of them works. Then you select by color. So once that is done, it will show you a pointer here to select the color. Select on the white part anywhere. So this will select the entire image, all the white sections of the image. Then next, what we have to do is we have to go to the colors menu header, colors menu in the header, and then click on color to alpha. What this will do is the selected color, that is white color, all the sections which are in white color, it will convert to transparency. So if you see here, the other than the black, everything else is converted into white. So now next, what I'll do is I'll unselect the selection that is currently going on. So I'll click on right click, or I can go to edit also, and then click on select, and then I click on none. So if you see here, the image is now transparent and the black part is there. So once this much is done, what we can do is we can fill in whatever colors we require. So I'll select red for example here, and I'll click on the bucket tool here in the menu. So if you see here, this section has turned red. So in the same way, you can click on any color in the colors option and then use it according to your needs. So if you are not much familiar with GIMP, and if you get stopped in the middle while using any feature, you don't know how to use a specific feature, then what you can do is you can Google it and you can search for the feature. Most probably you will find all the features that you need in the GIMP. The basic editing features are available in GIMP. Only for complex features, I don't recommend GIMP. You need Photoshop, but almost all the basic editing features are already there in GIMP. So here I am changing the hair color also, the color of the eyes. So basically, this is how you convert an entire hand-drawn image into colored. So I'm not going to color the entire image, but I think you might have got an idea of how this has to be done. So once you are done with coloring each section and your entire image is done painted, then what you can do is you will need either the image in PNG or JPEG format, right? So you go to files, you go to export. So I have already saved this, there is an export as option. So click on that, file, export as, and then you have to select the location where you want to save the file, and just give the name. If you want to save it as a JPEG, you give it as JPEG. If you want to save it as a PNG, then you can save it as a PNG. So I'm going to save this file as a PNG. So just give some name .png and then export. In case if you need some of the sections of the image to be transparent, in that case you need to use the PNG option only. In JPEG, I don't think there is an option to save the transparency of a image. So what I'll do is I'll update here PNG in the file name, and I'll click on export. So you will get an option of interlacing. Select that, unselect the save background color. So this is because I don't want any background color in this. I want the transparency part to remain as is. And then click on export. So what this will do is it will start saving the file. And once you are done, it will save the image in the same resolution as the original image, but you will have a modified digital art. So if you see here, I have made quite a number of images using this technique. So this is the same image that we were editing. So this is how I colored it. There is another image, this one. This is also I developed using the same technique. So basically, if you need any specific image and you are not able to get it on the internet, and most of the images on the internet are normally copyrighted, so it is always better to either use open source images or to develop your own images. in case if you you don't have access to a graphic designer or you don't have the budget that is required to make custom images, then you can follow this path. And your drawing skills are great, in that case you can follow this path and you can make your own custom images. You can use this in anywhere. You can use it to in your documents. You can use it in if you're an app developer. I am specifically using it for my app, for some sections in my app. So this is how I convert line drawings into digital art. I hope you like this video and found this helpful. Thanks a lot for watching this video and have a nice day.